What's up, Peep Squad? Peep Squad is in the building, baby. Please like, comment, subscribe, share the video. It'd be greatly appreciated. Peep Squad, let's get down to the situation. Let's talk about basketball wives. It is going down. Let's talk about the new people coming and the old people not being there. It seems like the cast is like, ooh, baby, what's going on? But in any event, let's get down to the situation. Let's talk about Angel Brinks. She is supposed to be returning to Basketball Wives, allegedly, and she's going to be bringing on her man, Rockstar, baby. And they're going to have some drama because, allegedly, Rockstar cheated on Angel with, you know, Lyrica. But in any event, when Lyrica was on Love & Hip Hop, Hollywood, so was Rockstar. He's the one that told everybody that he done slept with Lyrica. He wanted it to be known. He was bragging about the situation because he wanted to hurt, you know, A1 Lyrica's husband. So you guys let me know what you think about this situation. But in any event, so I guess they're gonna have that gossip going on. But let's talk about Angel. She's out here, she's a fashion designer, and she designs for Mary J. Blige, Little Kim, Beyonce, and a shit tons of other people too as well. She's out here in these streets making the money, baby, and she is with Rockstar. Now Rockstar is her man. They have started a trucking company, a trucking business together, baby. And Rockstar says that Angel completes him, and you know he's a fool, you know he got swag, you know he like to be in women's business, you know he like to run his mouth, you know he like to act like he better than everybody else, you know he try to act like he's the man and everything of that nature. So in any event, he's going be in the midst of drama. That's how it's gonna be, and I believe he's gonna be Angel's protector, because we know, you know, she ain't built for basketball wise, but right now she might be, because she done solidified herself and made her money without basketball wives, baby. But now being on basketball wife, she can do more branding as a fashion designer too as well, and bring on celebrities, because she is really tight with Cardi B. I mean, they're ace boom coon out here in these streets. But in any event, she didn't have a tragic dating life. But only thing I didn't like about Angel when she was on the show, she put her son on Front Street, baby. And, you know, he was already kind of like getting picked on at school. And then she had him on camera crying and talk about how he feels and all different things of that nature. It just really seemed like she was exploiting her son for the cameras. But in any event, she's back, baby. And she might be on Basketball Wives, the new season, allegedly, according to the Jasmine brand. So you guys let me know what you think about this situation. You think it's a good thing or it's not a good thing? But one thing is for sure, she is not messing with Malaysia at all. She don't unfollow her, she ain't her friend. And Malaysia was talking about her designs and her dresses not fitting and being cheap and tacky, baby. But in any event, you know, so therefore she's gonna have a bone to pick with Malaysia, you know, that old bone, you know, they just gurgitating storylines. But you guys let me know what you think about this situation. And then we're gonna have DJ Duffy back in the building. You know, she's a baby mama now, or well, you know, second time around, and she also has a man. You know, they live together, they have a happy life, Blase the Third, that's what they put on the gram. But she's not married to a basketball player unless her new baby daddy is a basketball player. But in any event, that's him on the screen, baby. So, you know, she's in a relationship, she's not married, you know, she's living like the way she's living, but I don't know what she's gonna really bring to the show. But one thing is for sure, she does not like Malaysia, point blank, period. And this is Brandy Mac Seals, you know, Ace Boon Coon, her girl, her peoples, you know what I mean? So in any event, she's gonna have some things to say, and she's been very supportive to Brandy Mac Seals, you know, over the years, especially on the gram, baby. But in any event, we're gonna see what she gonna bring. I don't know what she gonna bring. I don't know what storyline she gonna have, other than coming after Malaysia and chilling with the other girls that don't like Malaysia. So Malaysia's gonna be have to fight for her rights, because you already know Duffy is out here hungry and starving. So she gonna do what she gotta do to get in where she fit in, baby. And she might have a little bone to pick with Shawnee O'Neal for dismissing her and also being rude to Brandy Mac Seals. So we gonna see what she brings to the situation. And any event, let's talk about Miss British Williams. You know, she's gonna come on with her drama. Yes, British is coming on with whore drama, baby, and it's going to be off the chain because she's out here arguing with Lorenzo. She's busting the windows out his core. She is doing everything under the sun. She's been on the gram. She's been on the Shade Room acting a fool, acting up, doing what it do, baby. So she's hungry and she's starving out here in these streets. So therefore, she going to do what she got to do to get to where she needs to get, and she ain't going to let nobody stop her and whatever she's trying to accomplish, and she wants to be back on Basketball Wives. I thought she was going to be on last season, but baby, she wasn't. So I guess this season she's going to be on. So you guys let me know what you think about that situation. Lord have mercy, it is going down. We're talking about beef on top of beef that's going to be hitting these streets. We got British out here destroying vehicles of Lorenzo's core and beefing with him online. And his girlfriends, he's selling her furniture, her clothes, and things of that nature. And also, British Williams, she is not feeling Malaysia either. She done unfollowed her. So Malaysia's going to have a lot of beef out here in these streets. Baby, so according to the Jasmine brand, we got British Williams, we have, you know, Duffy, DJ Duffy, and also Brooke Bailey supposed to be on the show too as well. Brooke Bailey is married, but I don't know what these women are going to bring to the show because they ain't with no basketball player. They're not living a fabulous lifestyle, but at least Brooke is married, so it is what it is. Allegedly, she is. So you guys let me know what you think about that situation. As you can see, Angel Bricks, Brinks, and also Brooke Bailey and British Williams and Duffy, they are not messing with Malaysia at all. They unfollowed her. You can check it out on the BBWTINC Instagram, baby. So they unfollow Malaysia. So Malaysia's going to be swinging and banging because these ladies are starving to be back on TV. Other than Angel Bricks, but it seems like Angel Brinks wants to support her boyfriend, rock star, new business, and basically more branding, and being on a syndicated TV show is going to only elevate her. So you guys let me know what you think about this situation. And all the other ladies, Angel Brinks and Brooke Bailey and British Williams, are rocking with Brandy Maxill. And also Shawnee O'Neal and Brandy are kind of cordial now when it comes to Instagram. So it seems like Malaysia's being set up, baby, for the okie dokie. So it is what it is. You guys let me know what you think about this situation. And also when it comes to Shawnee O'Neal, you know, she got a new man out here in these streets. She's with Pastor Henderson and they are doing the damn thing, baby. You know, so I think Shawnee's going to be on her best behavior because she's representing the pastor and his church too as well. And let's get into the situation where Shawnee O'Neal, she dropped O'Neal from her Instagram name because she is with pastor now. She is with the pastor. So baby, it seems like she is really moving forward on this situation. She's serious about this, but I don't know if I will be serious about him, but in any event, let her have her day and have her happiness. It is what it is. So you guys let me know what you think. And then let's get on to Evelyn Lozada. She made an announcement not too long ago that she was leaving the show. Good riddance. See you. Don't want to be your baby. So she is out of the mix, but you never know. She might be coming back. And then we have Febreze. You know, I send my condolences to Febreze because she recently lost her grandmother. Sorry to hear that. But it seems like she may not be returning because Evelyn's not returning. And what is really her storyline? Because she's not connected. She's not really like Shawnee's girl or Shawnee's friend. And the big connection that she did have was Evelyn Lozada. But I don't believe it's over yet. They still need her to stir up the pot, basically. Malaysia needs some allies. She needs some friends out here in these streets. She is going to be feeling like OG was feeling, but even worse. Because the ladies that are coming for her are thirsty out here in these streets. And Shawnee don't care. And also, when we talk about Dom, I wish Dom would return to the show too as well. So she can get with Jennifer Williams and let Jennifer Williams know what's up in the situation. But Dom is out here thirsty too as well. You got to check her out on Instagram being thirsty, baby. She wants to be back on TV fast in a hurry. And of course, we're always going to miss OG. And we wish, oh well, at least I do, her and Shawnee would just sit down and have a conversation and hash it all out. Just sit down and talk. Like, Shawnee, you would have passed it now. You got to learn how to work shit out. But in any event, it's alleged that Kristen Scott is not going to be there. And this is Malaysia. Biggest ally, and it's alleged that she's not going to be on the show, so Malaysia's going to be swinging and fighting for her life. Kristen Scott has been dismissed. She has not been asked back. She's been fired. I guess she boring. I guess she didn't stir up the pot too much. But in any event, she's supposed to be not coming back according to the Jasmine brand. But it seems like they might bring her back if they're going to bring all Malaysia's enemies. Is she going to be ready to toe down? Is she ready going to be ready to go toe to toe if she does come back? Because, baby, there's a storyline defending your cousin, even though you couldn't defend CeCe, but you can defend Malaysia. So, we're going to miss OG straight up and down. And we know when it comes to Jackie, she is going to be there. And, you know, she has a little situation with Angel Brinks. So, we're going to see what happens. And it seems like her and Brooke Bailey did make up online. But once the cameras start rolling, all that shit that they do on Instagram goes out the window when it's talking about camera time. And Jackie is cool with Malaysia now. But I don't think she's going to be going toe-to-toe and defending Malaysia like that. But you never know with Jackie. She switched up all the time. So it depends on how big your boobs is and how big your booty is and how much you flirt with Jackie. She might have your back. But in any event, we have Jennifer Williams. She will be returning, and you know, her Malaysia are cordial and things of that nature, but Jennifer ain't stepping out to fight nobody's battle. But you know the girls are gonna come for Jennifer Williams because she's an easy target. Her and Angel Brinks are an easy target, you know what I mean? So we're gonna see what's gonna happen with this situation. And with the twins, you know, the sister Nora and the other sister, you know, they might come back. They might not come back. They might be friends of the show. They did, you know, Shawnee O'Neill's dirty work, so they should be able to come back on the show. Shawnee, you just going to use them and throw them out to the streets like that? They thought they was going to be pooping. They thought that they was going to be on and pooping on the show. But if you just dismiss them after one small season, only 8 episodes, that's a shame. Shawnee be out here using the girls, her and the people over there. And we have Eliza Morales. You know, she complained about Basketball Wife that she didn't fit in, that she felt uncomfortable because the girls wasn't agreeing with her. They was like, get a job, mother effer, get a job, work. So in any event, you guys let me know what you think about this situation. It's going down. It's all washed up, old storyline, old beef, no married to no big old basketball player, nothing like that. Like,